time, you think?
She's 14 again.
Yeah, no need to remind me.
This young girl who is so seemingly outwardly secure, but inwardly searching for herself.
My friend Charlie from California, he's a junior and plays volleyball for his high school.
Oh, junior. Well, he's obviously a very smart kid. LOL, laugh out loud, right?
Nice one, Dad.
It's exploring, I think, one of the big topics of our modern lives, really, and that's children, the way they use the internet, the way they relate.
This is a very seemingly functional family and intact. And even in that, there are forces that will just penetrate your safe haven. And this one in particular is via the internet.
I was just gonna send a photo to Charlie, but okay.
So seriously, what's this guy's deal?
Well, he's smart and funny. His brother is being recruited by UC Berkeley for football. And that's where he wants to go, but for volleyball.
Oh, right, the girls' sport.
I first started thinking about this as a movie about 7 years ago. I'm on the board of directors of the Rape Foundation.
That it was based on his real relationship with this rape treatment center, and it was from people's real experiences. And
it was something that I couldn't kind of shake. I've just been really thinking about it and consumed by it for years.
I think the fact that it's a passion project for him is very important because of the subject matter. I think I would be less comfortable doing a film like this if it was, you know, somebody's good idea for a movie, wouldn't that? It's more affecting than that. It's more personal, and because of that, it's more profound. It feels much more real.
Hi, it's me again. Where are you? I'm sitting on a bench just outside.
Annie?
Yes?
What's wrong?
Not 25.
I think that there's a fine line between people who want to get turned on and people who cross a line and violate.
When you find a soulmate, in the way that we found each other, then nothing else matters. And I thought you were old enough to understand that. I mean, you made me think you could handle this, Annie.
When you hear about an event like this, you think about the practical impact on the victim. You find out that the event is just the tip of the iceberg, that it reverberates not only through the victim's life, but it reverberates through her family, through her future experiences, and that it's not just the girl or the victim that has stuff to cope with, that the family has to learn how to deal. It sort of becomes a new reality for everybody.
You know, apart from Teen Chat, were there any other networking sites you used to communicate?
No, not really.
Did you guys ever speak on the phone?
You spoke to him.
You said his mother was sick.
Yeah, cancer.
Yeah, okay. Tell him you feel awful about his mother, that you really want to talk to him, that you lost an uncle to cancer.
I don't know.
You don't know what?
I just don't want to lie to him.
What are you talking about, sweetheart? He lied to you.
The subject of this film, it's incredibly provocative at the moment, and it is something that needs to be talked about and needs to be addressed.
Hello? Speaking.
We don't know exactly what's happened. What we do know so far is that we think she was assaulted by her alleged boyfriend 3 days ago.
She hasn't got a boyfriend.
Finding an actor who could really handle this material. Leanna has this genuine inexperience on a film set, inexperience romantically, and it was just became incredibly clear that she was the right choice. The casting of Annie was one of the most challenging aspects of the story because your entire movie hinges on this 14-year-old's performance.
It was hugely important, in fact, that we cast somebody who was pretty close to the real age.
And it's more easily forgivable what's happening when you have a 23-year-old actress playing 14 being seduced by a 45-year-old, and when you have an actual 14-year-old actress.
You could have cast somebody who was much more experienced, who was older, but the film wouldn't have the same impact.
And what I wanted when I watched Annie, when we found Annie, I wanted an Annie who would break my heart. And that's what I saw in Leanna. She broke my heart.
God, I'm so sorry.
They were very challenging scenes, and but having to work with Viola, she's such a fantastic actor, and so it was easy for me to feed off of what she was saying, and it was so believable, all these scenes, that, you know, it was a pleasure working with her, honestly. She was really awesome.
I can't tell you what it feels like to work with a director who understands acting and who absolutely respects your process and understands process.